Hi everybody, welcome to Aga Math. This is Rakesh. Today we are going to learn about the Venn diagrams. What Venn diagrams are called? Where do we use? Described by whom? Let us see now. These are the Venn diagrams that shows the possible logical relationship. Possible logical relationship between the finite sets. So we use Venn diagrams between finite sets where to find the logical relationship. And these Venn diagrams are described by the mathematician called John Venn. His name is John Venn, right? And he described these Venn diagrams in the year 1880. Okay, he's from England. He's native from England. Okay, so how do we use these Venn diagrams here, and what is the logical relationship between them? So to know about all this before, let us see the basic thing to represent the Venn diagrams. Let me take an operation of sets already which we have learned before, like a union of sets, intersection of sets, difference of sets, and also types of sets like subsets, proper subsets, and all this. So those all will be included. So and the representation of sets we have learned, like set builder form or list form, all this. Now we are going to represent the sets in a pictorial. We call it pictorial. That pictorial presentation of the sets is what? Venn diagrams, right? So let us see how do we represent these Venn diagrams. Here I take A is equals to set A is equals to, this is an example, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and B is equals to 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Right? Before you watch the video, subscribe it. Click on the bell icon for more notifications. Now, if they ask us to find what is A union B, what we do is we just write our elements together of A and the sets A and B. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is a way we do the operation of a union, right? Now if you would like to represent in the Venn diagram. So actually Venn diagrams are represented using the shapes like called circle or oval shape. Circle which is a round or oval shape. So in general we use a circle shape here. Let us take that. Now here I used two circles and this is one rectangular box, right? So the rectangular box indicates the universal set, that is mu. So this is a universal set and these are the two sets. One is A, one is B. So this set, this circle is set A and this circle is set B. Now I would like to fill this about like A union B elements in this. So first of all, whenever we would like to write the elements in this diagram which represent this set A and this is set B, we have to fill the common elements first of all. So what are the common in both of this? So common means what? A intersection B. A intersection B. In this intersection, we can see the common elements like 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. And these are here, if you observe, two sets which are indicated using the shape circle are overlapping sets, we call here. And also, you see that when they overlap each other, right? So this is a common region. If you observe, this is a common region for the set A and B, right? These two sets. So this is a common region for the both sets, right? So you fill the common in this like 3, 4, 5. So we can see now, and see this is a set A, 3, 4, 5, and we have 1, 2, 6. So this here I write 1, 2, 6, and B 3, 4, 5 already completed, 7, 8, 9. Now observe carefully here. A union B. A union B means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Means the common region and this everything. So that means here, how do we represent? Means when we have the elements, this is the way we write the elements which belongs to the respective sets. Then if there is no elements, how do we represent? How do we represent A union B? Let us see now. So here the rectangular box is about mu, that is universal set. This is set A and this is set B, right? Now A union B means what? The common region as well as both total together. So in that case I represent like this. How? That is what? A union B, right? So shade like this. So this is what whatever I am shading, and I am using the lines, right? These lines are horizontal lines. You can use any type of lines, or you can use any any pattern of lines or points, any pattern you can use, nothing wrong. But to which looks to be the simple and good, so I use it here. So what that it means, this indicates A union B, right? A union B. So, and also here you have to write it, A union B equals to, so this shaded region means I use the horizontal lines. So wherever these horizontal lines, that area is said to be the A union B. So this is about A union B. Clear? So when the elements are given, we feel like this. First of all, you have to fill the intersection part and then the write the elements set A. Now you can see set A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is set A and this is set B. Right? Now, then how do we represent A intersection B? Right? Let us see now. Here, A intersection B means only, intersection means common elements. Similarly, when the two circles overlapping each other like this, which region is a common region? See, this region is a common for both the sets A and B, right? So I represent only like this. So this part is what? A intersection B. So I do like this. A intersection B equals to. You have to represent, shown compulsory, you have to show like this. So what is A means? A intersection B, wherever the shading like this, so that part is A intersection B, means this is the part. This is a part of A intersection B. Clear? Everybody? So, A union B already we have seen, and A intersection B this is. Right? Now let us see few more about the difference of sets, like how do we represent A minus B and how do we represent B minus A. Right? Now, considering the same sets, that is A and B, how do we find A minus B? What is A minus B? Generally, when we see what A minus B means, only in A means, see, 1, 2, 6 are A, because these all are B, right? These all are even in B, and these are even in A and B, right? So only in A means 1, 2, 6. So 1, 2, 6. So only the region towards A but not with B. So what it is, this is what, so this indicates A minus B. How do we, when the elements are given we can take like that, but when no elements are given, how do you represent A minus B? Mean this is the way. So A minus B equals to what? This shaded region is said to be the A minus B.
right?
Then how do we represent B minus A? Let us see now. B minus A. If you would like to find B minus A, so that is 7, 8, 9. Right? 7, 8, 9. See, now when you draw the Venn diagram, it is easier to find all these. What is A minus B? B minus A. So B minus A means only B. That means it means only leaving this area. Right? It means this is what? So B minus A. So this is what B minus A. Not only the horizontal lines, you can use any, even vertical or diagonal, like slanting lines. I use slanting lines now. So it's up to us, how do we represent? Right? So here, B minus A. So what shaded region? This is a basic thing we are learning. So when elements are given, we represent and we just shade like this. But when there is no element, so this is a way how do we represent. So here in this video, we just learn what is A union B, how do we shade and how do we represent in Venn diagrams. And what is A intersection B? A minus B, B minus A. Right? We have few more representations about like A subset to B and all. So those will be learned in the next video. Okay? So this is what today. I hope you all understood how do we represent A union B. Right? A union B, A intersection B, A minus B, B minus A. So using these Venn diagrams, in the coming classes, we will see how do we solve those logical problems using Venn diagrams. See you. Thank you. Bye-bye.